Good day, kids. This is our Mark. Today, we have a new lesson. So, finding the GCF and LCM. So, we'll be using continuous division, prime factorization, and listing methods. So, let's proceed. So, GCF and LCM stands for greatest common factor and least common multiple. So, before we discuss briefly and thoroughly getting the GCF and LCM, let's have the definition of factor and multiple is all about. So let's have the example. So we have 8 and 15. So sa 8, madali lang kunin yung factor niya. So you will get just a pair of number na pag minultiply mo ay you will get a product of 8. So we have 1 times 8 and then 2 times 4. Therefore, the 1, 2, 4, and 8 is a factor of 8. So sa 15 naman, we have 1 times 15 and 3 times 5. So ibig sabihin, ang factor ng 15 ay we have 1 and 15 and 3 and 5. So sa multiple, mas madali kasi parang nag-skip counting ka lang dito. So factor is a number that divides another number exactly or evenly without remainder. So sa multiple naman, let's have 8. So ang multiple ng 8, paano natin makukuha? So ganun lang, 8 times 1, 8 times 2, 8 times 3, and so on and so forth. So pag minultiple natin yung 8, so we have 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, and so on. So let's have another example. So multiple of 15, we have 15, 30, 45, 60, and so on. So 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on, and 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so on and so forth. So basically, ang multiple, kung napansin nyo, is any number that can result in multiplying our given number, which is 8, 15, 5, and 2, by another or any number. So ganun lang kasimple yung ibig sabihin ng multiple. It's a number obtained by multiplying it by a natural number. Okay, let's have this 3 method in finding the GCF: continuous division, prime factorization, and the listing method. So let's have the continuous division by using the ladder method. So i-upside division lang ito, madali lang. So we have 12 and 16. So 12 and 16, ang concept kasi nito is you have to get the prime numbers as our divisor. So ano yung mga prime numbers na ito? Ito yung mga 2, 5, 7, 11, and so on. So ibig sabihin, isi tayo ng prime number na 12 and 16 na pwedeng madivide. So we have 2. So i-divide lang natin yung 12 divided by 2, and then 16 divided by 2, we have 6 and 8. So put it at the bottom. Next, meron pa siyang common factor. So repeat the process. So saan pwede siyang i-divide? So we have 6 divided by 2 and then 8 divided by 2. That is 3 and 4. Okay. Look at the number at the bottom side. So we have 3 and 4. May common factor pa ba siya o meron pa ba siyang number na pwedeng i-divide itong dalawang number na to? If wala ng common factor, so it ends there. So makukuha na natin yung GCF and LCM. So our GCF is ito. Itong nasa side na to. So we have 2 times 2 equals to 4. That is our GCF. And then multiply everything doon sa nasa side pa letter L. Yan. So earlier we have GCF of 4, i-multiply na lang yung 4 dito sa 3 at saka sa 4. So we have 48. So ito yung tinatawag nating parang conventional or traditional. Kailangan kasi mga prime numbers yung nasa gilid. Pero kung limited ang time nyo to get the GCF LCM, pwede nyo naman gawin to automatic pag nakita nyo yung 12 and 16 if you master the multiplication. So may isip nyo kaagad na ito ay divisible by 4. So pwede ka agad siyang ma-divide sa 4. Let's see kung tama yung parehas lang siya. So GCF pa rin natin is 4 and the LCM is 48. So, parehas pa rin siya dito sa non-conventional. Pwede nyo itong gamitin kung limited yung hours nyo to get the GCM and LCMs. So, let's have another continuous division by using the ladder method. So, we have 10, 20, and 40. So, upside division, if we flip lang natin yung division symbol. So, we have 10, 20, and 40. So, anong prime numbers ang pwedeng ma-divide dito? So, start tayo din sa 2. So, divide lang natin. So, we get a quotient of 5, 10, and 20. 10 divided by 2, 5. 20 divided 2, 10. 40 divided 2, that is 20. Okay, may common factor pa siya. Pwede pa siyang ma-divide. So, repeat the process until such time na yung ating bottom number ay wala na siyang common factor or relatively prime numbers na siya. So, we have 5, i-divide uli. So, repeat the process. So, we get the quotient of 1, 2, and 4. Okay, mag-stop na ba tayo dito? Kasi, ayan, tingnan nyo. So, hindi pa kasi meron pa tayong dalawang merong common factor. So, itong isa, okay na to, isa-set aside na to. So, ang GCF na natin dito is 2 and 5. I-multiply na natin to. So, hindi na natin isasama itong isang factor na to. So, dahil exempted na itong 1, kasi wala na siyang common factor, bring down 1 na lang natin siya. Okay, ito ang 2 and 4, so divisible siya by 2. So, 2 divided by 2, that is 1. And 4 divided by 2, that is 2. Yan. So, iniba ko na yung color nito kasi hindi na siya dun common dito sa naunang tatlong number natin. So, pwede na natin makuha yung GCF natin. So, ang GCF lang natin dito, itong factor na dalawa kasi ito yung common sa kanilang tatlo. We have 2 times 5, that is 10. And multiply everything. Itong nasa side hanggang dun sa nasa baba pa letter L. The LCM is 2 times 5 times 2 times 1 times 1 times 2, that is 40. Okay, let's do the non-conventional. So, automatic, pagkita nyo dong 10, 20, and 40, makikita nyo kagad na divisible to by 10. So, meron pa siyang common factor dito, yung 1, hindi nakasali. So, bring down 1 na lang siya. And then, repeat the process, 2 divided by 2, 1, 4 divided by 2, that is 2. So, ang ating GCF is 10, and LCM is 40. So, we have the same answer dun sa ating conventional and non-conventional or traditional method. Next, we have, okay, favorite ko tong continuous division. So, example, we have 15, 20, and 50. So, upside down division, ano yung possible prime numbers na pwedeng ma-divide dito? So, we have 5. So, divide lang natin. So, you will get 3, 4, and 10. Kapag dinivide itong 15 sa 5, 20 divide 5, and then 50 divide 5. So, pwede pa. Itong 3, wala na silang common factor nitong 4. Yung 3 and 10, wala na din. Pero itong 4 and 10, they have still the common factor. So, hindi pa tayo titigil dito. So, ano number sa common sa kanila? So, we have 2. 4 divided by 2, that is 2, and then 5 divided by 2, that is 5. So, itong 3 exempted na to, so bring down na lang siya dun sa pinakababa. Okay, kung prime numbers na itong lahat at wala na silang common factor, it ends there. So, we will be able to get the GCF. GCF would be 5, and our LCM is multiply everything, itong nasa side at itong lahat na nasa baba. So, we got 300 as the LCM. Okay, now let's have the second method. So, this is called prime factorization. Okay, from the label itself, prime, ibig sabihin, gagamit tayo ng mga prime numbers. So, we have 12 and 32. So let's try to break down this by using the prime numbers. So, ano yung mga factors nito? So, let's start with 12. So, 3 times 4, that is 12. So, yung 3 prime numbers na siya. So, hindi na siya i-factor. Itong 4 na lang. So, we have 2 times 2, that is 4. So, pag prime numbers na lahat itong nasa baba, okay, it ends there. Settled na siya. Let's proceed breaking down this 32. So, we have 2 times 16, 32. Itong 2, stop na dyan. 16, pwede pa siya. So, 2 times 8, that is 16. Itong 2 ulit, stop na dyan. So, we have 8, pwede pa. So, 2 times 4, that is 8. So, yung 4, pwede pa. So, 2 times 2, that is 4. So, pag prime numbers na lahat ng nasa bottom pinakababa niya. So stop na tayo dyan. So paano natin kukunin ang GCF and LCM? Okay, let's have the Venn diagram. Okay, I prefer using the Venn diagram. So yung 4 circles we have 12, and then the second circle is 4, 32. Okay, ang unang gagawin, look for the common factor, yung magkapareha sa kanilang number. Let's see kung meron. So we have 2, may 2 ba sa kabila? Yes, meron. So all you have to do is to put 8 on the overlapping a circle. So we have 2, meron pa bang magkaparehas ulit? So we have another 2. So ilagay uli dun sa gitna or dun sa middle. So pag wala na nakikita, okay, set na tayo doon. So we have the GCF na. So the GCF is 2 times 2, that is equal to 4. Okay, anong gagawin doon sa mga remaining numbers? So we have natira dito. So we have 3. Okay, put it on their respective circle. So dito sa 3. And then meron dito ang tatlong 2. So ilagay lang natin doon sa 32 na circle. So paano natin kukunin ang LCM? So all you have to do is multiply everything. Itong nasa labas ng circle, ng overlapping circle, at din sa kabilang side. So LCM would be 3 times 2 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 times 2. That is equals to 96. So imumultiply nyo lang lahat yun. So you will get the GCF and LCM using prime factorization. Next, we have, yan, the listing method. So, ginawa na natin ito kanina dun sa factor at saka dun sa multiple. So, we have, yan. So, anong factor ng 8? So, ganun ulit. Get a pair of number na pag-multiply, ah, you will get the product of 8. Same is true with 10 and 20. So, ito yan. Yan. So, mga ginamit natin mga numbers. So, ilalagay nyo lang yan dito sa portion na to, so, sa katapat nya. So, anong susunod? So, let's have the GCF. Ang GCF natin dito is 2. Ang greatest common na magkapareha sa kanila ay 2 lang. Yan. Next, we have multiple. So, multiples of 8, 10, and 20. So, para lang tayo nag-skip counting dito. So, ano yung pinakamalaking, pinakamaliit pala, sorry, na magkapareha sila na nag-appear? So, we have 40. So, ang ating LCM dito ay 40. So, that's how it works dun sa ating listing method. So, factors and multiple. Okay, let's have the what if. So, example number 1, we have 3, 7, and 8. Number 2, 11, and 5. Okay, what can you say about the 3, 7, 8? Do they have the same common factor? Okay, wala. Then sa 11 and 15, do they have the common factor? Wala din. So, pag ganyan, they are relatively prime. So, no common factor or factors, automatic, ang gagawin nyo dyan ay yung GCF nyo ay 1 kaagad. And LCM nyo is multiply everything, lahat ng given number. So we have 3, 7, and 8. I-multiply nyo lang lahat yon, and you will get the LCM, 168. So dito din, paras din sa number 2, relatively prime siya, wala siyang common factor. So GCF is 1, and the LCM is multiply lang, so you get 55. Another what if, yan. So we have example 15 and 45 and 20 and 80. Ano napansin nyo dito? Yung bigger number o yung highest number is divisible by 15. And then itong 80, divisible siya by 20. At yung 45 is multiple of 15. At yung 80 is multiple of 20. Pag ganun ang consideration na nakita nyo kaagad din sa number, if you master the multiplication o concept ng multiplication natin, so larger number is divisible to smaller number, or relatively multiple of smaller number. Okay, gagamit po tayo ng continuous division and prime factorization and listing method? Hindi na. Automatic ang GCF nyo dyan ay yung smaller number. At yung highest number, that would be your LCM. So, ganun lang. Okay, let's have a short exercises. Find the GCF and LCM. I'll give you a couple of minutes to answer this. Okay, you may start now. You're done. Let's check your work. Okay, number 1, we have 4 and 40. Number 2, we have 3 and 45. Number 3, we have 7 and 28. And number 4, we have 5 and 300. So, congratulations if you got all this correctly. Salamat. Again, this is Sir Mark. Thank you so much for watching and listening. Until next time, dun sa ating susunod na lesson na fractions na. Thank you.